Hello everyone, welcome to Take 5 at Goa Institute of Management. My name is Bhavyashree and we have with us today one of the most celebrated and best-selling authors of India, Mr. Ashwin Sanghi. Welcome to GIM, sir.
I'm delighted to be here. Thank you so much.
To have you here, sir. So, sir, one of my first questions is, you've chosen theological thriller and mythology as your topic.
Yeah.
Why the unusual but great choice?
Well, it's not as if, you know, there is an old saying that you don't go out searching for stories. Stories search for you. So in my case, that first story, when I went to Kashmir and I saw that particular tomb, which is called Rozabal, that got stuck in my head. And it was just such a fascinating, deeply fascinating story that I wanted to invest the next 2 years in actually researching it and then eventually writing about it. Now, once I was already in that space, then by default, your next few books tend to be in the same space. But I have consciously attempted to remain as versatile as possible. So for example, my crime thrillers with James Patterson have no element of mythology or theology in them. And similarly, my non-fiction books in the 13-step series are far removed from what I do. So my aim has been that don't get compartmentalized. I don't want a situation where I'm simply known as a mythology slash theology writer. I would like the world to know that I can write beyond that.
So, sir, do you believe there's a secret formula to a successful book? Anything that you particularly follow?
I would say that there are probably three basic rules. And they are simple enough. The first paragraph of your story should be like a Bombay pothole. It should suck the reader in with very little hope of being able to get out. So it should suck your reader into the story and then keep him trapped right there. And that's where you want him to be. The second part of it is that every chapter should end with a hook that propels your reader into the next chapter. And typically nowadays we are living in a world of declining attention spans. So it's always better to keep your chapters short and snappy because increasingly people don't have the appetite to read long-winded stuff. And finally, I would say the third rule is that when you end your book, end it with a conclusion that's satisfying. But most importantly, it should make your reader look out for your next book. Because otherwise, how will you be a bestseller?
So, sir, I'm sure you read a lot. Any personal favorite authors, any books that you'd like to recommend?
I would say my all-time favorite is Paramahansa Yogananda with Autobiography of a Yogi. That's a book which I've probably read in excess of 15 times. It's a book which I keep going back to because I find that it is, every time I read it, there is stuff which I pick up for the first time. There is a second book that I go back to often enough, and that is not out of fascination, but it's out of jealousy. That why can't I write like that? And that would probably be Midnight's Children by Salman Rushdie. All-time favorite would probably be Dan Brown, The Da Vinci Code. It's what set me off in my journey on mythology and theology.
Sir, you've spoken today about the story of failure. Any tips for the budding writers that we have here at GIM?
I don't think it's only about the world of writing. It's about any endeavor that you will take up. There is bound to be a failure rate associated with it. In some, the failure rate is higher. I think what is common across all of them is figuring out how do you retain your balance, your positivity, while this failure is going on. You know, I mean, for someone like me, coming here to your institute and talking about failure is easy because I've already become successful. So in fact, when you are already successful, failure tends to get glorified. The problem is that when you're going through it, it is not so glorious. So you need to figure out a way as to how you can psych yourself to remain positive and remain patient and continue to persevere in the face of all of that adversity. That is the critical element. So it's much more of a mind game than anything else.